faithful Honourable President, all the office bearers, students and friends. Let me speak in English. Perhaps I'll be more expressive in that language. First of all, I really congratulate each and every one sitting here for being here. All this confusion, some people may not have had time to be here, others perhaps may not be wanting to be here because they may not be wanting to rush the management on the outside. You are not one of them. The dogged manner in which Students' Union pursued and stood the ground, I congratulate the Students' Union and all of you here. Having said that, I will not dispute facts related by Abdul Bhai, particularly pertaining to his case. But I don't know anything about that case, and he knows, so he has personally experienced that. So I was thinking, things are not as bad, and the fact that Abdul Bhai is speaking in one of the most eminent educational institutions and is free to speak is also one of the facts that we should know and have a balanced view. Normally I speak most privately. Today, let me try to speak from wisdom, the wisdom has. Because the stridency has already come through Abdullah's voice. What I'm trying to do is, rather than generalize one case, and I said I'm not disputing anything about that case at all, whatever you said, we have lived through it, and it is not that innocents are not convicted. Although the doctrine is that the legal doctrine that judiciary is supposed to follow is that let 100 guilty go scot free, but not one innocent should be punished. But we know this is just a doctrine. It doesn't mean no innocents are punished at all through this system. What I'm trying to do is try to place stethoscope in this entire system, because unless we examine clinically where the fault is and what needs to be fixed and what should be fixed, unless we address that, we'll keep complaining here and in many other forums without achieving anything. So that's my attempt today. The first thing that I want to note, where problem occurs, because of paucity of time, I'll just try to highlight some of the main issues before us that we should be fixing and addressing. The first issue that I would like to place before your consideration is the politics of the day. And when I say politics of the day, I don't mean only last 4 years, but even before that. And the fact is that the politics of the day and the security agencies classify crime into two categories. It is not legal categorization. I was talking to Abdul Bhai when we were having sitting tea in the canteen. And this is not a legal classification. There is no legal classification of crime. There are offenses. Offenses are listed down and punishments listed accordingly. But the security agencies and political ideologies classify crime into two categories. Those that are anti-national crimes, crimes against the nation, and those that are ordinary crimes. Terror, we were told in 1993, after the bomb blast in 1993, that terrorism is directed against the nation and therefore is an anti-national crime. Once the crime is classified, labeled as anti-national, then, so to say, security officers feel free to take liberties with those who are arrested and accused of that crime. You know, they see each accused as not as an offender, not as a criminal, but an anti-national who is out to destroy. In 1993, there was no present design of nothing. In 1993, and some other events now claims to be secular. And what more? Who was blamed or was accused of Muslim appeasement? Appeasement of minorities. These things were happening during their regime. So anti-national crimes and otherwise criminal violence, these are ordinary crimes, just like robbery takes place and people need to be punished, at least some of them should be punished. It's alright if we can't punish everybody. And we are consoled that if there is robbery, oh, forget it now, get on in life. Likewise, criminal riots is not an anti-national crime. It happened, people reacted to Sabarmati Express or to some other cases and get on with life and forget it. Get on with life. But anti-national crimes cannot be forgotten. They have to be. And it doesn't matter whether you get the real culprits or fake culprits accused. And as Abdul Bhai was telling us that in the cases that we had experienced and seen from the prison, often it is fake culprits who are arrested because police also feels the heat and pressure to resolve those cases, to solve those cases and put somebody on trial. And often they don't get real. And often we are told, mastermind has been arrested. Whether it is some Bhatkal or some, you know, I was counting how many masterminds have been arrested. Mastermind has to be only one. Mastermind is a mastermind. There can't be several masterminds. But mastermind is arrested, put on trial. And yet, there is another bomb blast. Again, some other mastermind is found. And we feel, oh, now the problem should be solved. Yet, there is another bomb blast. Fourth, fifth, sixth, how many masterminds are arrested? So, this heat and pressure on police to solve these anti-national crimes. And they themselves are fed to believe, or led to believe, that Muslims are, their loyalty is suspect. So, if we arrest an innocent anti-national, innocent member from an anti-national community to solve an anti-national crime, and then put them to gallows or to whatever, it is all right, we'll get promotion, we'll get reward, we'll get, you know, accolades in the media, case is solved, the heat on the police is off. But then somebody must ask the question, if the case was solved, if the police went to the root of the cause and, you know, uprooted the whole mechanism, the whole terror cell and system, whatever, from the root, how come other bomb blasts are happening? And on continuous basis. Either the police has not found the real culprit, and that's where Abdul Bhai's appeal is very important. You will be victim, you are a potential victim, not because police is not going to arrest, but if the real culprit who has done the bomb blast is not caught, then that person will be encouraged to carry on. And there's no guarantee that the next victim may not be you. You are equally sensitive. You are equally worried about every death, whether the death occurs because of criminal violence or terrorism. We are equally concerned with all, and we want to prevent them. If we want to prevent them, get the real culprit and not fake culprits. Let's put the pressure. So first of all, this classification of crime into anti-national terrorism, which is anti-national, and criminal violence, which is all right, and then ordinary crime, get on with life, and forget it. Ho gaya, so ho gaya, now that's all the reaction. They are always told now. Now, okay, forget it. If you get a few Hindus convicted, it will create a bad blood in them and it will worsen the criminal problem. So, in interest of peace in society, please now forget. And there should not be any condition. As a result, there is no condition. In criminal violence. Compare how many people died in anti-national crimes and how many people died in not anti-national crimes. If you add up, I added up from 1993, because that's when the terror problem started, although we can go back to Mathuram Godse, the first terrorist, so on and so forth. I'm not going into all that. Let's assume since 1993 terror cases started, and if you add up, because they give figures, 287, 187, 2006 last, you have all those figures. It won't go up beyond 1,000, 2,000 at the most, to accelerate India and improve. This is what the anti-national crime, and not anti-national crime, Stephen Wilkinson, they added up. In our Center for Study of Society and Terrorism, we monitor these figures. There are 40,000 casualties. Our figures and Stephen Wilkinson's figures tally and add up. And this is from media reports. Media reports which underreports criminal violence. Government figures that underreports criminal violence. If you take government figure of 2002, riots in Gujarat, the total they say is 500, a little more than 500. And an official figure, if you count those who did, went from camp to camp and found out, they say 2,500, easily not less than 2,500. But you add up conservative figures, 40,000 casualties. See the huge difference? 12,000 people died. From 1961 to till date. See the difference? One is classified and we are asked to forget it, and the other is anti-national because Hindus have been targeted. Alright, we accepted this classification. We did not question, when I say we, I mean people of India. We did not question this classification. The heat on the police. And under heat, police then did whatever they did. Then comes, if terrorism is anti-national crime, then comes acts of terror which target Muslim community. And then the perpetrators are Hindu political ideology people. Let's call them Hindu supremacists. And very clearly distinguishing Hinduism as a religion and Hindutva as a political ideology. It believes in establishing, in overthrowing the constitution of India, establishing a Hindu state which is authoritarian in nature and where there is no democracy. It is a political ideology. We are talking about that political ideology. So whenever I refer to Hindu supremacists, please do not identify it with ordinary Hindus. I think there are, in India, there might be of the total population 0.00000000001%. And I'm talking about those Hindu supremacists, who are politically, sometimes in social media, people refer to as Marxists. They are 0.00000001%. I don't know how many zeros to add, but I'm talking about them. Then came terror, in which these Hindu supremacists were involved. One doesn't know that organic links with RSS. Let's assume that were none. But the link with RSS, Dange from Indore, was murdered. And let me also tell you that the RSS individual, Indresh Kumar, one RSS leader, Indresh Kumar, was also under investigation and has been named by Swami Asimandan in his statement that he gave. Not to police, the statement given to police magistrate. The statement that he gave to the magistrate. But when you give a statement to a magistrate, a confessional statement to a magistrate, then the magistrate first of all asks you to reconsider, because you could be given the severest punishment on your confession. If the person still insists, the magistrate will say, okay, I give judicial custody to you for at least 15 days, think about it. Consult your lawyer, consult your friends and your relatives and all. And then come to me and say, I'm ready to confess. In such a confession, Swami Asimandan gives detail of how they placed bombs, who all were involved. They placed bomb at in Samjhata Express, Makkah Masjid, Ajmer Dargah, etc. etc. And a few places. And one of the person he names is Indresh Kumar, who was to arrange for finances. One of the person refers to is the statement given by Swami Asimandan, who wanted to confess. And you know why he wanted to confess to his crime? Because in jail he was very lovingly served by a Muslim youth, a young Muslim prisoner. He was saying, Swami, Swami, rendering all kinds of services and serving, etc. Swami asked, why are you in jail? And that fellow says, I'm convicted for Mecca. My brother was convicted for Mecca Masjid bomb blast case. I used to meet him in prison. I am accused of giving a mobile phone to him, and I am in jail. Swami says, you have no hatred towards me. Why should I have Swami? But I am accused of the same crime. He says, no, I have none. I forget the name of this man. Muhammad Khalid. Muhammad Kalim, provided by Karachi, and said Muhammad Kalim. And Swami feels the remorse that for the crime I have committed, this good human being is in jail somehow, because of somewhere because of that, this Muhammad Kalim is in jail. And he wants to correct himself and he gives his confessions to the magistrate. We don't know whether RSS is organizationally linked or not. And I must say that Indresh Kumar, although under suspicion and although named by Swami Asimanand, was never investigated. Perhaps because of the weight of the organization, the strength of the organization, who protected, how he was protected, or whether police really did not find anything against him, difficult to say. That will remain in people who handle that case. But terror cases which were supposed to be anti-national, suddenly, if Swami Asimanand is involved, if Pratna Singh Thakur is involved, if Colonel Purohit is involved, if Swami Dayanidhi is involved, then they are not anti-national crimes. So the long and short of this is, from this you try to deduce that what anti-national crimes are, they are those crimes undertaken by Muslims and targeting Hindus. Those crimes are anti-national. Rest all crimes are tolerable, acceptable, or whatever, and people should forget and get on with that. This dualism is problematic, and this is what is driving our criminal justice system, the prejudices. I would, in the limited time that I have, let me read out some statistics before you, which should open our eyes. And my humble submission is that yes, Islamophobia and prejudice against Muslims is informing criminal investigation, but it is not the whole malaise. The malaise also lies somewhere else, in the criminal justice system that we have. And we should focus, we should be focusing on how to improve our criminal justice system. Unless we do it, innocents can be in jail and are in jail. And they will be not only accused of terror crimes, but they will be accused of right from robbery to all kinds of crimes. And unless we fix our criminal justice system. So, look at this terror crimes. The police disposal of this crime, why he had to spend 9 years in jail, and in some cases, Amir Khan spent 14 years in jail. And 14 years of jail, your life is finished. After that, there is no life left for you to live. You will not get a job. He was lucky because he was employed in Anjuman Islam as a teacher, and his institution took him back. He had to fight a little bit, but still, it took him back. Of course, he's fighting for his wages that he lost during this 9 years. He may or may not get, but others will not get jobs. Amir Khan is finding difficult to get jobs. Shahi Rajmi actually was a terror accused. He came out of the JAB, did his LLB, and started fighting cases as a lawyer for others. But all are not lucky to get that life back. What happens to in Amir Khan's case, mother expired without him getting to see her face, and it means quite a lot when you are not going. But why are people languishing in jail for so long? Just look at the disposal figures by police. 2006 police disposal of offences against state, that is terror comes against that because it is an anti-national crime, might be. The pendency of cases before police, when investigation was not complete, was 3,040 in 2016. In that year, these are NCRB data, government data, that NCRB collects. In that year, 922 new cases of for investigations came to the police. So that makes nearly 3,962 cases, which is nearly 4,000 cases. 4,000 cases pending. How many of those cases were investigated and disposed of by police, in which either a charge sheet is filed or the accused is allowed to go free? Out of those 4,000 cases, 4,000 odd cases, about 4,000 cases, only 180 cases were disposed of in the sense of filing charge sheet. Whether that charge sheet is right or wrong is another issue. And whether on that charge sheet that person will be acquitted or not is quite another issue. Do you know this amounts to 90% or only 10% disposal case? And do you know number of years in which this charge sheet will be filed? They are supposed to file within 90 days. The difference in anti-national crime is, and that's the problem. Normally, if the police does not file charge sheet within 90 days, the accused is entitled to bail. He can be out. If you, within 90 days, you could not dispose of the case and you could not file a charge sheet, there is nothing in it. Police can continue to investigate, but the accused will be out. But in this cases under special laws, that is UAPA, OSPA, TADA, etc., etc. If in these cases there is a longer period, that detention can be without investigation, it can go on up to 2 years, and even then, if the police has not filed charge sheet, they will not be entitled to bail. So there are strict conditions for bail. So this is one. Only 10% disposal of cases and 90% police has not acted upon or not completed their investigation. Look at the, in the same year, disposal of cases by court. I'm just trying to point out some issues that we need to fix. Because it can be anyone, you know, it can be any crime, and all people who are accused of these charges or any charges, any offense, suffer in this criminal justice system. Court disposals. In the year 2016, I'm just taking one odd example of that year. Similar is the case in every year. In 2016, 1,256 cases were pending in court under special law. Crime against state under that category. 232 new charge sheets were filed, and so those cases, pendency of those cases added. Total disposal of cases was abysmally only 33 in the entire year. And that amounts to 2% disposal of cases. 97.8% or nearly 98% cases continue to be pending. And they be pending for 14 years, 15 years, 16 years, 20 years. Then trial, after that appeal, the High Court, Supreme Court, etc., etc. Maybe why might all these five people who have been against whom who have been sent to gallows in your case, they also, you know, maybe on the basis of archer and arrow distinction, they also might be spared the gallows, although maybe one doesn't know the Supreme Court will find a guilty, they will give them convert the sentence into life imprisonment or not, that we don't know. But they may be spared gallows. Maybe. We don't know. But for this, if this process goes on till say 14, 16, 20 years, for that long year they spend their life in what is called as undasset, that Abdul Bhai was describing. Imagine for 20 years you don't see light of the day. There is nobody you can talk to. Practically, if I make you sit for 4 hours not talking to anyone in a room, you'll feel the heat of being isolated. 20 years, 14 years, 16 years is too much of time to be spent in that fantastic. I think that is one of the reasons that we need to fix this classification of crimes into anti-national and not anti-national and other crimes, which is political, which is not legal classification. Having such a slow disposal rate, there has to be some accountability in the system, in our criminal justice system. Unless a case is investigated within such and such a period, or unless trial over in such and such a period, the accused should be entitled to bail. I have seen, both as a lawyer and I have gone to prison also, I have seen people in Gujarat for under prohibition case pending 16 and 18 years. Just because they have nobody to bail them out, and so on and so forth. We need to fix this. I'll end by just saying what remedies that we need to fix our criminal justice system. There have been many studies. I'm not the person who is going to invent. We need to build pressure for fixing criminal justice system so that it is fair to all. We need to counter this ideology which says certain crimes are anti-national and see offences only as legal offences and stop classifying offences into national to be tolerated and anti-national not to be tolerated. And not to be tolerated, of course we should not tolerate. Even if it is not anti-national, but at least don't send innocents to gallows and sentences. That, I think, our political education of society at large. And the third remedy that I would suggest is a strong civil liberties movement and legal aid, which comes to the help of all innocents, all accused, because they are, all accused are entitled to fair trial. Our doctrines of our legal system, our jurisprudential doctrines are all right. There's no problem with that. There's problem with criminal justice system. And finally, I would say we all should raise a voice for compensation of those who have been acquitted after such a long time. Because that is what will deter the society, the bugs, people like the bugs. Put them behind bars, like morons they keep on repeating, like sheep following their leader, keep on repeating the same thing and building that pressure. If anybody who has suffered this criminal justice system wrongly, then the police officer also should be held accountable for and accountable to, and the victim compensated. You will find that in criminal law cases, there were practically no convictions. And then I told you 40,000 casualties, injured, people who suffered, 12,000 deaths in criminal violence and no conviction. Except after Gujarat, when human rights movement became aware and said, no, now we will not tolerate. They went to the trial court, they went to high court appeal, they went to Supreme Court, court SID appointed,
it was years and years of battle and hard work that led to some convictions in cases, in Gujarat riot cases.
Nirodagam, if I'm not mistaken, 31 people were convicted. I may be confusing the figures a little bit. In Nesara case, some were convicted. Nirodagam Patiya case, some were convicted. But they were good soldiers.
The conspirators, the abettors of the crime, and including police, who the victims said provided fuel from their own official cars for burning and all, for burning houses and killing people. They have not been. Thus, Sri Krishna names several police officers for being involved in riots in Mumbai. Only Tyagi was put to trial, and you know how? As soon as he is arrested, he gets himself admitted into hospital, and till the date of his acquittal, he spent his time in hospital. That's how he was restored. You see, I can't go into details of how these terror cases were investigated and the torture that Yunus Sheikh had to face. He died. He was killed by police in police custody, and then they made out a case as if he had run away. Now, CBI has found them, has found that Yunus Sheikh did not run away. He was killed inside police custody. But those police officers are not yet brought to justice. So those police officers, and all of them get promotion. Tyagi got promotion, he became Director General of Maharashtra. Not one police officer involved in these kind of cases, nothing has, you know, has not suffered a tiny bit. They have all been promoted, they have all got accolades and etc. etc. No condemnation in the media. Division, division is not considered for murder, or they can get away with anything. And we see that Banjara, D.G. Banjara, police officer whom we referred to, as soon as he was discharged from this case, he said, "Achhe din aa gaye." So, kiske achhe din aaye, aur kaun suffer kar raha hai, it's clear to us. We need to fix this thing. Compensation, strong civil liberty movement, and legal aid cell. Political education, where we stop classifying crimes into anti-national, and these are the three things that I recommend. Thank you very much for giving me your opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Now we'll open the floor for questions. Due to paucity of time, we'll take a bunch of questions, and I will request you to answer.
Could you come here and ask your question? I'll be a little louder. Yeah.
Sir, I said, sir, in every bomb blast and terror attack, people from all religions are used to that. But on what basis police or government used to catch or arrest or accuse the people like Wahid sir and sir innocent Muslims only? Where is the loophole in our system? And why people were not raising a voice against the police, those who used to arrest them and used to get promotions?
Like
phenomenal. मतलब मैं भी यहाँ पे मुंबई में था 1993 में जो राइट्स हुए थे और हमने देखा कि पुलिस जब आगे उनके गड्ढे जुटा को जलाते हैं या जो भी मतलब पुलिस कुछ नहीं करती वहाँ पे बैठ गए तो ये जो इस हद तक हुआ है ये तो दिस इज बीन अ प्रोसेस एक प्रोसेस में रही है ऐसा नहीं कि 1993 में आज कई बार ये ऐसे किसी तरीके से गलत हुआ लेकिन यहाँ पे स्टेट इज यूज एज इंस्ट्रूमेंट marginalize, crush a certain community or and then spread a certain popular rhetoric. तो ये जो एक process हुआ है बहुत सालों से आज desecularization हुआ है communalization is much running over. So I have a point of disagreement कि आज कोई वाइट साहब को या आज you know त्यागी साहब को कोई condemn करने वाला नहीं है या वाइट साहब के हमको कोई सिंपथी जताने वाला नहीं है मास नहीं थे ये इसलिए हो रहा इतने सारे विधायक हो गए चार साल मोदी सरकार में माइक्रो इकोनॉमी इतने बड़े ब्लंडर हो गए इतना बड़ा घोटाला हुआ जो ये हिंदुस्तान की हिस्ट्री में नहीं हुआ है आज फिर भी हम कह रहे हैं कि हम मोदी को ही लेकर आएंगे हम नहीं करेंगे तो ये जो डिसिक्युलराइजेशन माइंड का हुआ इतनी इतने बड़े प्रोसेस इतना बड़ा लंबा प्रोसेस चला है उसका ये एक दो दिन की बात नहीं है तो इसको हम कैसे बदल सकते हैं क्योंकि अगर आपको सिविल सोसाइटी मूवमेंट खड़ी करनी है अगेंस्ट जो युद्ध हो रहा है तो सबसे पहले तो एक मास सिक्युलराइजेशन की जरूरत है तो ये कैसे हो सकता है आपका उसका क्या क्या कहना है
वन मोर क्वेश्चन
सो माय क्वेश्चन टू यू सर सर आई जस्ट सेड अबाउट द क्राइम्स दैट आर एंटी नेशनल एज सच सो हाउ डू यू like further categorize those crimes into like the crimes based on religious identities and on the based on ethnic identities because I come from a state that is like which is registered from the last 30 years and people are also those who revolt against the state they are actually termed as anti-nations and this is the same stage of like of acquisition false acquisitions they are like even I come from Assam and this is Alpha movement and all so there are false accusations over and on even the people have been in jail for 20 years 15 years 16 years for false accusations so how do you actually categorize these which you have to say that anti-national based on ethnic identities and also based on different perspectives
sir I wanted to ask like the first question was what is the movement called in the system that the Muslim community is being victimized. But I wanted to ask that on our part, like on the Muslim community part, what are the loopholes in the Muslim community that we are giving? So we'll take another set of questions after you answer.
Yeah. Pardon me, I have missed out quite a lot. How Khatib was killed inside the jail, etc. Whole lot of things. How the staircase is. Something very stark, how these staircases are being. Now, one, I would again say that crime needs to be depoliticized. Every crime needs to be punished. And guilty of those crimes needs to be punished. Someone involved in the crime needs to be punished. And I think we'll have to do a lot to train our police force. I have been invited several times, but not now. Since last 4 years, that invitation has stopped. But by National Police Academy to sensitize the police about minority culture. That they are different than the mainstream culture. It is diverse,
so is diverse Hindu culture, and on the basis of culture, neither our constitution classifies culture as superior, inferior, national, anti-national, separatist, etc., etc. But that's, that is what we see in media, we see everywhere. What it will need to do is sensitize police officers, but also have also placed in systems things like command, chain, responsibility. For the crime committed by, say, the lowest officer or any officer, his superior also should be responsible for lack of supervision on that. So this command, chain, responsibility is gaining currency everywhere in the world. We need to adopt that. That will depoliticize the entire system. The second thing that we need to have is police complaints committee. Any group, any individual who has been victim of police investigations or police actions, whether during demonstrations, whether during investigation of crimes, etc., etc., the victim should have some forum which is easily accessible, which is effective and efficacious remedy to complain against individual police officers who violate law. These are the that is making police system more accountable. There's a third, these are noble, not only noble, they are practically work in various countries. Community policing. Policing with community, for the community, on behalf of the community, and not on the community, on any community. Today, nationalism means, or it is taken that who are nationalists? North Indian, Hindi speaking, upper caste, males are considered to be national. Rest, capitalism or national loyalty of rest are suspect in various degrees. We have caste system and we have hierarchies, and in these hierarchies the least, the bottom has more duties and no rights, and the top has more rights and no duties. Some are born nationalists and nationals, others, whatever their conduct, their nationalism is already suspect. South Indians, lower caste, female, women, etc., etc. I think this idea we have to contrast. Our constitution talks about diversity, pluralism, inclusion, and we need to educate people more and more about our constitutional values, not to take more time on this, because I can that partly answers your thing also. And anybody, northeast is also not north, and only Hindi speaking are loyalists and rest all are, because they are in power. Actually a small clique which is in power, and when I say power I don't mean only political power, within bureaucracy, educational institutions, religious institutions, cultural institutions, there is a network that is dominated, and they believe that only our culture is national and others are less than national, and Muslims are completely anti-national. We see anti-Dalit sentiments, anti-women sentiments, anti-LGBT sentiments. The same thing are, it affects a larger variety of this thing. Issue with, I think, Muslim community is a victim community. I don't think anything they will do will improve the situation. They have condemned terrorism and violence enough number of times. They have taken yatras, Hindus have not done it. They have taken yatras, they booked a train journey from and undertook that from Delhi to Hyderabad, passing through all the places where terror attacks took place. After attack in Mumbai on 26/11, Muslim community refused burial to kill terrorists inside Muslim cemetery, saying that if they are terrorists, they are not Muslims and they have no place. Now those who are terrorists are not, cannot be Muslim. Now this, after all this strong media keeps on harping, one Bhatkal, one Kapil Siddiqui, one Abdul Wahid, etc. They keep repeating daily, every evening there is a war with Pakistan. Every evening on media there is a war with Muslim community, there are communal riots, etc. We see that. I don't think Muslim community can do anything that will work. I think we need to, because every non-Muslim also is as much a victim. All are. We have to just educate people to make them realize that you also are wicked. Does this mean there is no fault in the Muslim community? No, there are plenty. I and my organization, and we have been fighting against Muslim fundamentalism all our lives. You know, we need to question our practices, especially how we treat our women, triple talaq, on all those issues we need reforms. The Muslim community catches my throat when I talk about all that, and the Hindu community catches my throat when I talk about communal violence, etc. So I am also killed by both of them. But there's a lot we need to do. You know, education. Muslim community has taken to education in a big way, and in fact, they are excluded from education in a variety of manners. There's no time to go into all this. But I think a lot Muslim community needs to do, but I don't think on terror they need to do it. They have done enough. They are a victim community.
What are the reasons? If India-Pakistan, the partition is the only reason for us to be
defeated? I'll tell you, keep my finger on the problem?
Yes, sir.
The cultural gatekeepers, North Indian, Hindi, male, upper caste, they want to monopolize power and they will demonize every other community, and they find reasons and excuses to demonize every other community irrespective. You know, they'll keep on searching. If there was no partition, yet they would have Muslim very poor, their population is increasing, they ruled over us, they demolished our temples. All this is concocted, all this. And they'll find anything that they'll keep throwing mud at people who challenge their power or their supremacy, Hindu supremacists, their supremacy. Alright. And whatever sticks, sticks. Whatever does not stick, they put it. Love jihad did not stick. But quite a bit of it is sticky. So partition is one of the things. So I don't think, yes, I don't think Muslim community is responsible for partition. That's another issue. Jinnah is, others are, including from Congress, including Vallabhbhai Patel and Nehru. Vallabhbhai Patel is Hindutva hero now. They don't have their own icon. But he also, in his own way, contributed towards partition. So I don't think Muslim community is responsible. In fact, Muslim community fought partition, was opposed to partition. This is not time. I would have summoned historical facts and placed before you for your consideration why I am drawing this conclusion. There is no time now. But I don't think Muslim community was for partition. And as a result, one took his very few people went to Pakistan, migrated to Pakistan. Well, you know, the tiny community of Muhajirs who migrated to Pakistan are suffering there. Rest all chose to India as well, in spite of violence that was taking place after partition on both sides of the border.
किस तरह से मुहिम चलाए, ये जो आपका सवाल है।
तो
लेकिन बायसनेस की जहाँ तक बात है, जब हम पुलिस कस्टडी में थे, एटीएस सरान के हाथ में हमने पांच जन्य बुक दी, पांच जन्य बुक जो है ना वो आरएसएस का माउथपीस, तो आरएसएस अपना माउथपीस एटीएस के पुलिस अफसरान के दफ्तर तक पहुंचा दी थी, उसको पढ़ते थे और उसमें जो जहर उगला जा रहा था उस तरह से उनका माइंड सेट हो रहा था। तो ये पूरा का पूरा जो मामला है, मुझे आपको पता है छूटने के बाद कलकत्ता का स्पेशल टास्क फोर्स एसटीएफ ने मुझे इनवाइट किया प्रोग्राम के लिए, और वहाँ के चीफ ने मुझसे कहा कि पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट के अंदर बहुत ज़्यादा जो बायसनेस है, हम आपको बुला रहे हैं कि थोड़ा सा हमारे लड़कों को सेंसिटाइज कीजिए। प्रोग्राम के लिए मुझे बाकायदा दावतनामा देकर के मुझे वहाँ बुलाया है। तो ये बात सही है कि वो बहुत ज़्यादा जो उसमें बायसनेस है, पूरा उनका माइंड कम्यूनल हो गया है, और ये एक दिन का काम नहीं है, पूरे अरसे का काम है। तो इसमें हम और आप ये कर सकते हैं कि आवाम के अंदर जितना हम आवाज़ उठा सकते हैं, इतनी हम एहतजाज कर सकते हैं, हमको उतना करना चाहिए। अब सुनने के बाद जो कैदी आता है ना, वो दो ही काम करता है, वो अपने बीवी बच्चों के साथ रहता है और वो चाहता है कि अच्छे से अच्छा खाना हो। तो ये जेल में उसके पास ही दो ही कमी होती है, बीवी बच्चे नहीं होते उसके करीब और उसको खाना भी नहीं, तो वो दो काम करते हैं। लेकिन आप बताइए, मैं अकेला निकला हूँ जो सुल्तानपुरी के शेर के मित्रा कि मैं अकेला ही चला था जाने में मंजिल, मगर लोग साथ आते गए कारवा बढ़ता है। अकेला ही निकला हूँ, जो मालूम पूरा डिपार्टमेंट वर्स्ट है, पूरा सिस्टम खराब है, लेकिन इसका मतलब ये नहीं होता कि हम हाथ धर के बैठे रहे। हम मरते दम तक अपनी आवाज़ को बदल करना चाहिए और अपनी आवाज़ को लोगों तक पहुँचाना चाहिए, सच्चाई को रखना चाहिए। अब क्या हो रहा है, इस वक्त हिंदुस्तान में हाल ये है बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट के बाद संडरवादी के कॉम्प्रोमाइज वाली सिचुएशन, कॉम्प्रोमाइज कर रहे हैं, सरेंडर करें हो गए, छोड़ दो, कुछ नहीं होता, कोई बदलाव नहीं। तो हमको सरेंडर नहीं करना है, हमको कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं करना है वापिस से, और इस शेर के साथ कि सुतून और दार पे रखते चलो सरों के चराग, सुतून और दार पे रखते चलो चलो के सरों के चराग, जहाँ तलक इस पल की सीना डाल चले।
मंत्री इसमें यूपी जो सबसे बड़ा स्टेट है,
सबसे ज़्यादा मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन है देसी और 19% मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन है वहाँ से एक एमपी नहीं है मुस्लिम तो पॉलिटिकली वीक है जो हिंदुत्व मैं अगर हिंदू और हिंदुत्व में फर्क करता हूँ हिंदुत्व जो है उसका इन्फ्लुएंस सारी पार्टीज पे है स्ट्रांगली पॉलिटिकली कनेक्टेड है उनके बंदे मैंने कहा ना कि कल्चरल फील्ड में एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन में रिलीजियस फील्ड में ब्यूरोक्रेसी में मंत्री पद में हर क्षेत्र में तो उससे पुलिस वाला डरता है वी हैव टू मेक पुलिस लेस बायस तो करना ही है सबका बायस है मेरा भी बायस है आपका भी बायस है लेकिन हमारा बायस हमारे पब्लिक ड्यूटी में नहीं आना चाहिए दैट इज वन थिंग वो करने के लिए हम अकाउंटेबल सिस्टम बनाएंगे सिस्टम वेयर पुलिस ऑफिसर्स कैन बी हेल्ड अकाउंटेबल फॉर वायलेशन ऑफ ह्यूमन राइट्स ऐसे सिस्टम बनाना है तो कितना भी बायस होगा उसको पनिशमेंट नहीं चाहिए उसको नौकरी से सस्पेंड नहीं होना है उसको प्रमोशन चाहिए ये सब करने के बाद उसको प्रमोशन मिलता है तो इस प्रकार का पैरेंट इन्वेस्टिगेशन या कम्युनल वायलेंस में दंगाइयों का साथ देकर उसको प्रमोशन मिलता है तो बायस के लिए भी करता है और इसके लिए भी करता है तो आई थिंक वे टू फाइट ऑन टू फ्रंट्स और सेकेंड मैं बार बार कह रहा हूँ कि प्रॉब्लम ये है कि एक छोटा वर्ग अपर कास्ट मेल हिंदी स्पीकिंग लॉटिंग है ये एक छोटा वर्ग अपने जो डिस्प्रोपोर्शनेट पावर उसके हाथ में है कल्चरल पावर सोशल पावर रिलीजियस पावर उसको रिटेन करना चाहता है जस्टिफाई करता है कि बाकी सब कम नेशनल्स है और एंटी नेशनल्स है ये तो उत्तर भी बनाई है उन्होंने उसके बेसिस पर वो जस्टिफाई करता है खुद के पावर करके हम नेशनल इसलिए हमारे पास हम ही नेशन का हित को संभाल सकते हैं कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन टॉक्स अबाउट डाइवर्सिटी democracy, accountable system. That is what directive principles of state policy tell us. Directive principles of accountable government की कल्पना है और वो हमको अच्छी करते हैं हम नागरिक citizens जब organize होंगे ऐसी system बनाने के लिए accountable system बनाने के लिए तो I think everybody will benefit. That is my opinion. And of course, political education against demonization of Muslims and Islam is one of the fronts that we have to fight. But only that will not suffice.
Sir, I
will start to agree that there is a thing here that if you are taking a special laws, if you are taking a special law, then you are taking a special law, कि अगर किसी पुलिस अफसर ने किसी को बेगुनाह फंसाया साबित हो जाता है तो उसको सजा मिलेगी या उसके खिलाफ केस चलेगा वगैरह वगैरह कहीं पर भी बात नहीं तो हमारा और आपका काम मिला है जहाँ स्पेशल लॉज हम बना रहे हैं जहाँ कन्फेशनल स्टेटमेंट स्पेशल लॉ है आम उसूल ये है कि मैजिस्ट्रेट के सामने जो कन्फेशनल स्टेटमेंट दिया जाए वो जो एविडेंस कोर्ट में रहेगा लेकिन स्पेशल लॉज के अंदर पुलिस अफसर के सामने जो बयान दिया जाता है वो भी एविडेंस बन जाता है कोर्ट में क्लिंचिंग एविडेंस बन जाता है और उसको एक्यूज के खिलाफ यूज किया जाता है तो आप में ये होना चाहिए हम को इतना पॉलिटिकली इतना प्रेशर डालना चाहिए असल होता क्या है समाज के अंदर कोई कानून कोई बिल आया जिसमें डिबेट हो रही है आपको पता है मोपा जब महाराष्ट्र की असेंबली में डिबेट हो रही थी एमसीओसीए हमने उसकी पूरी बुकों का उसकी पूरी मिनट्स बुक हमने मंगाई थी असेंबली से जिस वक्त ये डिबेट हो रहा था उस वक्त सबसे ज्यादा फोकस इस बात पर किया जा रहा था और इस बात के लिए कानून बनाया जा रहा था कि अंडरवर्ल्ड को कंट्रोल करना ये एक्चुअली कानून अंडरवर्ल्ड के लिए लाया गया लेकिन आप देखिए बाद में जो है टेररिज्म पे और मुसलमानों पे जो सबसे ज्यादा इसका मिसयूज हुआ है तो उस वक्त हमको बेदार होना चाहिए उस वक्त आवाज उठानी चाहिए ठीक है आप किसी के लिए नया कानून ला रहे हैं जिसमें एक क्लॉज होना चाहिए पुलिस को जो अकाउंटेबिलिटी की बात है पुलिस को आपको पता है जब मालेगांव ब्लास्ट केस का जजमेंट आया यानी नौ मुस्लिम नौजवानों को कोर्ट ने बाइज्जत बरी कर दिया कोर्ट के एक आदमी ने मुझे कहा कोर्ट के आदमी ने बोला अगर इंडिया से बाहर कोई केस होता ना तो पूरी की पूरी टीम रघुवंशी के साथ जेल में लेकिन आप देखिए रघुवंशी को उसके बाद प्रमोशन मिला जिस वक्त 26/11 अटैक हो रहा था वो वीटी स्टेशन के बाहर खड़ा था और जो है हेमंत करकरे जो गाड़ी में बैठ के गया और पूरी टीम को जो है सफाया कर दिया। तो ये पूरा सिस्टम हमारा ऐसा है ना, हमारे केस में जो आयो है उस आयो को बाद में प्रेसिडेंशियल अवार्ड। तो पुलिस इतनी माइटी है, इतनी ताकत और इनको मारे कुछ भी करो हमको कोई पूछने वाला नहीं, हमको कोई पकड़ नहीं, हमको बल्कि इनाम मिलेगा, हमको अवार्ड मिलेगा। तो ये चीज जो है खत्म होनी चाहिए, तभी जो है कुछ हम इसको कंट्रोल कर सकते। और हमारी आवाज नहीं चाहे कमजोर है तभी भी है, लेकिन अपनी आवाज को हमेशा बुलंद रखना चाहिए।
One doesn't know what will be the outcome, but
and then the Arabian judgment was a questionable judgment in my opinion, even as a lawyer. In my humble opinion, it was a questionable, but then there are correctives. Appeal was admitted, etc. Justice Gokhale, while admitting the appeal against Allahabad High Court order, said this is Panchayati Raj, Justice Loda and Justice Gokhale, both of them said this seems to be a Panchayati judgment. Aadha tumko, aadha, one third is ko, equal, it's not according to law. Alright, so they are correctives. And little bit more transparency in Panchayati. So individual judges will be biased, they will have their bias, but then
सबसे पहले इरफान इंजीनियर सर का और वाई सेक सर का शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहूँगा इतने शॉर्ट नोटिस में कि हमने एक दो बार ही बोला और सर आ गए और मैं अपने सभी साथियों का भी शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहूँगा कि इतने सारे असाइनमेंट और एग्जाम हैं और इतना टाइट शेड्यूल है उसमें से टाइम निकालकर यहाँ पे एक प्रोग्राम में उपस्थित है मैं फिर से आप सभी का शुक्रिया अदा करना